Joseph, you do welcome to the Coffee Pod. My name is Shishi Zed.
Drink the coffee, it'll make you feel better.
You know, it's always a good time when I get to react to like a DJ Envy topic. Because I'll be honest, ever since I experienced the disappointment of realizing that DJ Envy was against progress, the progress of men having platforms back when like Kevin Samuels was growing in popularity and other podcasts, Fresh and Fit, and a bunch of people. Right at the time, I really wasn't. I was still coming up, but I remember him just hating on everything, hating on the message and the logic behind everything that was going on. Even though someone like Kevin Samuels was saying, "Hey, high value men exercise options, or they're more likely to exercise options, or may cheat." And just like Derek Jackson, all these people who disagreed, what do we come to find out? Well, they're cheaters themselves.
A lot of times when people go through things like cheating, the man treats the woman poorly at home.
Yeah. Right.
But our sex life was good. He was always giving me compliments, mm-hmm. very generous. Everything was fantastic. He was a wonderful father. He never failed at that. I really didn't see any red signs.
Wow.
And when I found out, for me, I knew that it was going to be over, because my entire life being with him, that was my hard line.
Yeah.
That's the line you don't cross.
Yeah.
So when I found out, I hired a divorce attorney.
Wow.
I even began to prep my kids. And it was so bad in our home. And it was very bad for him professionally. And it started to spill over into his work life. He couldn't perform. And as a radio personality.
Yeah, you gotta be on.
You gotta be on.
Every day.
It doesn't matter what you're going through.
What was happening?
I was losing everything. You know, I'm losing this person that really held me down, was there from the start, didn't care about money, didn't care about anything, just cared for my well-being. And then my family. I felt like a letdown. I felt like a failure. And, you know, like I was Rashawn at home, but in the streets I was DJ Envy. Mm-hmm. So
right.
It was two different people. And
I didn't know DJ Envy.
Let's check out a few of these comments, see what the people had to say. A woman here says she stayed with him, so what's the point, really? That's a good question. What's the point? She stayed. And a lot of them stay. Women are willing to forgive infidelity a lot more depending on the value status of the man. It's just what it is. Now, is it right? Is it wrong? That's a different argument, right? I don't think men should cheat. Will women deal with cheating depending on where that man ranks in accessibility to women, how many women are chasing him, throwing themselves at him? You got to take those things into consideration. And guys, like I always say, people who you should be the most weary of are people who swear by everything that they'll never make a mistake, never cheat. But ever since that, getting back to the main point I want to make here, we got to watch this video. Getting sidetracked. As you can tell, I wasn't really happy with DJ Envy's stance on male empowering platforms. All right, guys. So in this video, DJ Envy shares how his wife caught him cheating. And the video is actually captioned, "DJ Envy got caught by the oldest trick in the book." No more wasting time. Let's get it.
My wife had an intuition that I was cheating, and she played poker with me. It was like, "Look, I got a call today. I know what happened." And she started running down what she knew what happened.
She was bluffing, though.
Bluff.
Was she really?
Bluffing. Me to death.
Are you bluffing. Sure she was bluffing, or did she know and she just needed the clarity? Because that's how women usually are. We usually
know. But there was no proof. So it was just what she felt, but she was bluffing.
Bluffing.
And then I told on myself. And then when I told on myself, it was like, "Oh, thank you for telling me." And she had no clue.
Damn.
So
he told on himself, bro. Oh, man, let's keep watching.
It did. Yeah.
We are so good.
So at that point, it was like, damn. But you know, I've been with my wife since 15 and 16. So it was like, she was like, "All right. Marriage is over. Relationship is done."
Just like that.
Done. Rap city. Right. Done.
All right, guys. So there you go. You heard it for yourself, man. Now, let me say this. Since 16, 15 years old, that's impressive. That's impressive. Now, with that being said, the last thing I remember posting about was his wife going on a 20-day vacation, girls trip or something like that. So the post read, "Twitter reacts to DJ Envy's wife taking a 29 days girls trip vacation." And it's got the photo here with him and his wife. First comment here says, "Wife, he took a leave of absence on the marriage. Tough." Another person here added, "20 days? Damn." Can't believe it. Somebody else added, this was a chick. She says, oh, she most definitely getting her lick back. With the crying emojis, still. And why is this funny and why is this even news? Well, because you think back to the last time the DJ Envy was trending. The last time I actually reported on him on my channel was when he was having some marital issues with his wife. Most people look at DJ Envy like a sin, right? Let's just keep it real. He was having some issues with his wife, man, in the bedroom. You check it out for yourself.
We got together so young. He was my first, he was my only. And I was very inexperienced aside from sex. You know, before him, the furthest that I'd ever gotten was second base.
Yeah.
Before him went up my shirt and I thought that was a big deal. So we were both turtles in our relationship. We waited to have sex to our 1 year anniversary and he made it very special and, you know, romantic. But we were two kids that, you know, didn't really know what we were doing exactly, but we had fun figuring each other out. Most young girls and even many, many, many women, I'm sure so many women can relate, but you don't know how to achieve an orgasm.
Yeah.
A lot of women have no idea what it feels like to have an orgasm through sexual intercourse. You know, they know how to do it themselves or they know how to do it through oral sex, but through sexual intercourse, a lot of women just don't know. Now, if you don't know, how do you expect your man to know?
Mm-hmm.
I especially didn't know. So we would be intimate and he would be putting his best foot forward, like, he is in the business of satisfying, just all around.
All right.
Just no. I'm talking about.
Oh man! Look at that. Look at the guy's face. Listen, if you're gonna get on a public platform and talk about your bedroom life with your wife, just know that the rest of us are looking at you, and we know that this was not what you wanted, right? For your woman to get on a public platform and basically tell the rest of us that you're trash in bed. Listen, man, I'm not saying the couples don't have issues in the bedroom. All I'm saying is, do we really need to know about their issues in the bedroom? I don't think I want that coffee.
No, I'll have a tea, actually.
Let's keep watching.
Your mentality overall.
Just like, all around.
Just in life. Like, he lives to make me happy. And he...
Oh, this is too easy. This is too easy. Do you guys notice a pattern here? He lives to make me happy. Does that sound familiar? It does to me. It sounds like Will Smith, right? Will Smith, who did everything to please his wife. Will Smith, who planned his wife a surprise birthday party. I think it was for like her 40th or something like that. If I'm wrong, let me know in the comment section down below. And she didn't appreciate it. Will Smith, who literally destroyed his whole image, career, and money to stand up for his wife. Guys, what am I trying to say here? There's a pattern in certain dynamics of relationships that are going downhill, right? And I'm telling you right now, this is one of them. I have a video where I talked about Will Smith 5 months ago that took off recently and everybody's saying, oh, you were right, you were right. Oh my gosh, it's like you knew it was gonna happen. Listen, it had nothing to do with me being right. It's just when you understand the natural balance of things, how you should carry yourself when dealing with the woman, well, then it's really easy to predict when things are going to go very wrong. And this is the type of situation where things are going to go very wrong. No woman should think to herself that you live to please her. But let's continue listening more about how DJ Envy can't please his woman in the bedroom.
He puts his best foot forward in that realm. So I would see him trying and really going to work. And I'm sure so many women can relate. Like, you want to reward that man for that work. And the only reward that you have to offer is an orgasm. But even if I didn't feel it, I would still be performative. So yes, I was faking it. But once you start, how do you stop?
Right.
How do you climb back out of that rabbit hole? You can't really have a conversation about it.
Wait a second. Once you start, how do you stop? So first she says she can't feel it. Am I the only one that caught that? Right? She can't feel it. Of course, she's talking about when he's busting those cheeks, putting in all that effort. She can't feel it. She can't feel it. I'm sorry, man. I can't believe this is being said on a public platform. This is just, it seems very emasculating. Even though it might be the truth, All I'm saying is, damn, like this though, right? And you think you're helping people? Because I don't think so. And not only does she say, I couldn't feel it, she also says, I was faking it for so long, meaning, was this for the majority of your marriage? All right, let's get back into it.
Got it now. So I actually did it to myself, but what's more important is the fact that it had nothing to do with him. Right. He was doing everything that a man could do to please a woman. The problem was that I didn't know my own body. Mm. And
you couldn't communicate what exactly you wanted.
Exactly, exactly. I had to learn that first. And what the problem was, I was so busy performing and putting on a show that I didn't take the time to be pleased. I didn't take the time to enjoy it because that wasn't my priority. My priority was him. And that comes from a place where, you know, ever since we're young, we're sold these false narratives that women are sex objects. Women are here for the pleasing of men. Women are toys. You see it on billboard ads. You see it on the cover of books. You see it in, you know, car magazines. You see it everywhere. Sexy women draped across something, advertising something. So we're kind of subconsciously led to believe those things. And for me, this is how it played out in my life.
Controversial statement. You're going to hate me. But have you ever thought that maybe some of that is a little bit true? Have you ever thought that maybe women are sex objects? Doesn't mean that they're just sex objects, right? I mean, let's be honest here. Men enjoy women's bodies to a higher level than women enjoy men's bodies. In fact, I think women understand and see an attractive woman and enjoy their body, sort of like a toy. I'm sorry, I just got to be honest here, right? All I'm saying is this. We get fed all this stuff that she's talking about all the time about, like, women are not sex objects and this is that. But what about men? We definitely know that men are success objects, right? The women use men to level up in status, right? She saw something in DJ Envy, decided to get with him, marry him. And he obviously saw something in her beauty, right? Maybe it's possible that women are sex objects and men are success objects. Now, in no way am I promoting that over-sexualizing men or women is a good thing. Just something to think about, man. Let's get back into it.
And everything is all good there now, right?
Oh, yeah, he's awesome. I figured out my problems.
Hurt my heart, though. I ain't gonna lie. I hurt my heart. I might have cried a couple of times, but we
no.
It helped our relationship even better.
But on a more serious note, me doing that was very, very detrimental, and it put into effect the fall of a series of dominoes that hurt our relationship in the absolute worst way. It was actually one of the reasons why he cheated. Mm-hmm.
So do you feel like, so how did that conversation?
BS. I call Cap. I'm sorry. I don't like that coffee.
Drink the coffee. It'll make you feel better.
Nope. I can't drink that coffee. I'm sorry. DJ Envy cheated because he could. Plain and simple. He saw something and took an opportunity. She caught him one time. He probably cheated more than once. He got caught. Right? It wasn't some... It's not, of course, women hate this, and I'm not over here encouraging men to cheat. People shouldn't cheat, right? Unless if you have an agreement with the person you're with, don't cheat. But I am saying this, men cheat differently from women. Women like to justify cheating with men like, oh, what was I doing wrong? You could have been doing everything right. Literally, everything right. I know it's crazy. And that man could just step out.
So how did that conversation even come about? Like, Envy, where you were like, am I not performing enough? Or were you at some point like, you're not performing enough? Or like, how did that come about?
One night we were in bed and we were having sex. And she was just, I remember in the middle of it, she was like, yes, but no. And I'm like, yes, but no what?
Something like that.
Yes, but no what? And she was like, we got into like a argument. And then she was like, well, you know, I don't be having an orgasm. She didn't say it in that. She speaks way more eloquent than I would ever. And I was like, what? And she was like, I don't. I'm like, no, yes, you do. I hear it. Like, yeah, ah, ah. And then she was like, no.
What?
I'm like, every time? And she was like, yeah. And then that just crushed me because I thought I was putting in work. Like, I'm sitting there thinking I'm
you know, Big Daddy Long Leg, you know what I mean? Like, you know, and she's sitting there like, no, not at all. So it really hurt my heart. Like it hurt me because for that time, I thought I was pleasing my wife. I thought I was pleasing, you know? You hear all these stories of women talking about their girlfriend. Oh girl, he was so short. Oh girl, he ain't doing nothing. And I feel like they laughing. Now I feel like that's what my wife was doing. Yeah.
All right, there it is, guys. Oh man. So guys, before I wrap it up here, I'm gonna check out a few of these comments. You guys know how we do it. This first commenter said, "This some Will and Jada shit," right? With the facepalm emoji. I agree. This commenter says, "I'm not faking shit. You and that ego gonna learn today." I'd be like, to the left a little bit. Okay, now stay like that. Don't change shit. This commenter says, "I'm tired of being involuntarily put in these people's business." I feel that, man. This commenter says, "They still on the cheat tour? It's been years." This next commenter says, "I can't give any energy to faking it. Let's talk about it so we can get it right. If that's the case, communication is key." This final comment says, "Faking in the bedroom for 10 years? Absolutely not." Which leads me to my final conclusion that DJ Envy's wife is probably gonna leave him. That's what I think. And the fact that she's confessed to faking orgasms for this long, I'm like, you don't even find this guy attractive. Well, if you don't find this guy sexually attractive, then why are you staying? That's what that leads me to ask. And then I remember that, oh yeah, this guy has status and has some fame. But the sad thing is that fame doesn't last forever. And once that fame is gone, I think she's going to leave. That's not me wishing she would leave. That's just me being honest and giving you guys my honest opinion on DJ Envy's situation with his wife. Hey guys, as always, let me know what you guys thought of the content down below. Leave your comments. And of course, I appreciate you for checking out this episode of The Coffee Pod. Until next time, man, I'm out. Peace.